just want to ask you, have you heard of this 成语, 画龙点睛? Anyone remembers? O-level Chinese? Okay, so this is a Chinese idiom which literally means to dot the eye when you paint a dragon. And there's a story behind it which goes like this. A long, long time ago in ancient China, there was this famous artist whose name was Zhang Sen. Okay, let's call him Bob for now. One day, Bob was invited to paint some dragons on the walls inside a temple. But he left the dragon's eyes blank. And people didn't understand his intention and forced him to fill the eyes. And immediately after Bob painted the eyes, the dragons came into life and flew away. Today, I'm going to talk about service learning. And to me, service learning is like the eyes to the dragon of our education. It brings classroom lessons into life by showing us what the world really needs and how we can apply what we learn to solve real life problems. And now I'm going to tell you my journey in service learning through three simple stories. Before I tell my first story, let's picture. I was from an all-girls school where everybody wears sneakers. And on our annual service learning day, my class decided to raise funds to organize a carnival for children from low-income families. And what appeals to secondary school girls more than bubble tea? So we ordered them from Koi. And the greatest thing was to sell one bubble tea at $5. Generate a high profit margin. Did you just say it's expensive, Hadira? Actually, no, it's from Koi. But many of our customers also made the same complaints. And in the end, I had to tell them this. You see, when you donate $5 to these children, you get a bubble tea. So at the end of the story, we managed to raise enough funds to organize the carnival. You're so slow, guys. Thanks. So we managed to raise enough funds to organize the carnival. But did we do it all with the right intention? Isn't the fundraising sale supposed to raise awareness too? We were so caught up with the process of activity, which is to raise most funds possible, that we kind of lost sight of our initial intention in doing it. Nobody remembers what the name of the organization we partnered with, but everybody remembers how much we sold one bubble tea for and what flavor of cupcakes we baked for the sale. And this mindset can follow us even when we go out of the country. So here comes my second story. I got it from a friend who went for an overseas service learning trip with the school. So that summer, her class was assigned to help a rural primary school in Cambodia. And half the class got a task to build a dining area. But the truth was, the place was already built and all they had to do was to build the cement flooring. But still, they couldn't finish the work and had to hire a few locals to help them on the last day. And another half of the class went to help repair tables and stools. But being the pampered kids, they couldn't even hammer in a nail properly. And you know what? While they were overjoyed to finally make some progress, the 10-year-old Cambodian children just took the hammers and easily accomplished the work in just a few minutes. What is the meaning of service learning? If we are just paying the locals to get our hands dirty? If the so-called needy are actually better at helping themselves? Don't you think that this kind of service learning is a form of charity more for us than for them? And if so, can we take a chance to do the service learning differently? Can we take a chance to break away some of these stereotypes? Can we break away from fundraising skills that focus more on the product than the cost? Can we break away from service learning trips where we have to do manual labor to build our 21st century competencies? Can we break away from service learning trips where we learn more than we serve? Can we make it more sustainable, more meaningful, and more creative? So here comes my first. Last year, my friend invited me to join a voluntary teaching trip to Thailand, yeah, where your chicken rice is from. And we were going to help with a rural primary school. And the whole team agreed that we should make this trip unique from all the other teaching trips. And the first initiative we took was to raise funds online instead of a fundraising sale. Our intention was to present our course more clearly to our donors with the help of images, text, and videos that the focus won't be on the products or the free gifts they are going to receive. But we're still a bit worried that nobody would actually donate to us if they couldn't see us holding a tin can in front of them. But it turned out to be fine. Not only did we manage to raise enough funds to hit the target, we tripled it. And although it may not seem to be a lot of money, it was more than enough for us to purchase whatever we want for the sale. Sorry, for the trip. And the trick is, getting from Taobao. But the real problem is not with money. It is related to the nature of our activity. Short-term voluntary teaching trips like ours usually do not have long-term impacts. In fact, the lessons we planned for the children were initially of a touch-and-go nature. To benefit them in the long run, we figure out that the old wisdom, teach a mental fish rather than eating a fish, did apply. So, instead of teaching them English vocabulary, we taught them how to use the dictionary. Instead of teaching them science discoveries, we taught them how to think critically and ask questions constantly. Instead of showing them music theories, we taught them how instruments make sounds and allow them to make their own instruments and music. And this is how we leave a long-term impact. Right after we left, the school just continued with the syllabus as normal. And the children even complain that their lessons are not so boring compared to ours. And in fact, the principal even banned us from teaching them Chinese and math next time because they just couldn't afford that the children lose interest in these two principal subjects. Hearing this, we were initially a bit disheartened. But again, we asked ourselves, who are we helping and what do we need? Again, we were so caught up with the structure of the curriculum, of what we want to show them, of kind of change we want to make. And we forgot that this service learning trip is not for a sense of fulfillment or an experience that we put in our portfolio. We wanted to serve the children wholeheartedly and to give them what they really, really need. Love, companionship, encouragement. So we took a chance, we made a change, and we broke away. And we also made mistakes. But mistakes did not stop us from taking more chances, making better changes, and continuing to break away from stereotypes. And guys, here is a challenge for you. Will you take chance? Thank you.